very excited to be sitting here. As always, the beginning of the season is a very, very exciting time. And, you know, Kevin, Brian, and the men's team have set a pretty good standard for themselves and obviously for us as well with their Final Four appearance last year. I know they would like to go one or two better on that standard this year. And we are certainly doing all we can do to follow in their footsteps. Again, very excited about the season ahead. We've got some interesting and exciting additions to the team, including, and very importantly, my new associate head coach, Grant Kimball, who's in the back there with a nice UVM green tie on. Grant, say hello. Very excited to have Grant with us this year. He was at North Dakota the past two seasons. Previous to that, 4 years at Wayne State University. Did an outstanding recruiting job at both places, and we're very, very pleased to have him with us this year. I know the girls have taken to him, are very excited to have him on board as well. So really important part of our program, and we're very pleased to have him. You know, we've got four freshmen, small class coming in this year. And before I get to them, again, just important to say how excited Grant, Mike, and I are to just see how our team is going to progress this year. We're obviously all a year more experienced in Division I and in Hockey East, and we really feel like we've made some big, big strides last year in our sort of team mental toughness approach, dealing with adversity, you know, game to game, but more importantly, sort of minute to minute within each game. And we're very excited to see how that's going to play out this year. We really think it's going to be an important ingredient in our season, just responding at the right times and in the right way in and throughout all the games. We've got a great returning group. The vast majority of our leading scorers are back, including Peggy sitting here. She was our leading scorer as a defenseman last year. Really settled in nicely for us and helped us quarterback our power play. She and Aaron Barley Maloney did a terrific job in the second half of the year. We really, really improved in that area last year, and we hope to make further improvement this year. It's going to be an important part of our playoff drive. So a very good experienced group. We should be more capable in every area, as I just mentioned, and that'll be good for us because we got a pretty tough non-conference schedule again this year. We're pretty excited about, including the opener once again against McGill on Sunday. Immediately following the men's game against New Brunswick. McGill are two-time defending Canadian University champions, so they'll be a real good test for us, and it was an excellent game last year. We lost 1-0, played extremely well, and we're looking forward to that on Sunday. And I know the girls are real anxious to get going and play some games, as we all are, and we've got six home non-conference games following Sunday's game to prepare for our home Hockey East opener Halloween weekend against Northeastern, which, again, talking about playoffs, huge games for us right off the bat. They're a team that we're going to be battling with for a playoff spot, and no better way to start the season than jump right in and get right after it as we try to chase down that first ever playoff spot.
We gained a lot of valuable experience last year. Last season that can be utilized this year with our returning players. But that being said, probably our biggest challenge this year is to focus on what's important now. It was, we're real proud of the fact that we were able to contribute a lot to our rich tradition here, known as Vermont hockey. But at the same time, this is a new journey, and we can't be focused on what happened last year. We've got to move forward, which isn't always as easy as it seems. We get asked a lot of questions, I know, from the media and certainly around town about last year's season. So it's something that our guys are going to have to be aware of, that we just concentrate on, again, what's important today and move forward and not live in the past. So that's going to be a challenge for us, but an exciting one. And I know our guys are really, really focused and excited about a new journey. Again, we've got a great group of seniors. We've got some tremendous leadership with Brian Roloff to my left here, Kevin Miller, who's in attendance, and Patrick Cullity. I think he had class today. But those three have done a tremendous job leading the guys in the early going here, you know, not only throughout the summer, but also through the month of September when coaches aren't around very much due to the rules and regulations. So I want to thank them and commend them for on the job they've done. And certainly they're not alone with their leadership. They've got a great core around them that may not have letters on their jerseys, but are very good leaders as well. Much like Tim, we welcome in a new staff member to our program, actually two staff members. Technically, Joe Gasparini was a former player of ours here. We're excited to have him. We put him to work today, so he's out in Western Canada doing some recruiting. He couldn't be here, but now he's going to be a great addition to our program. And John Gobe, who is a student manager through his 4 years here, is now moving into a position with us as director of hockey operations. So we're excited to have those two guys with within our program now. So not only do we have new players, new captains, new coaching staff, but we also have a very, very good recruiting class of freshmen. We haven't had a lot of time with them. I know everyone wants to know who I think will be the impact players in that group, and it's tough to tell early on. I mean, I think all of them have something special to offer our program, just depending on how quickly they adapt to college hockey. But I really like the fact that they came in great shape and they're hungry and want to learn, and they're just great people. I think you can go a long way with that. That's been the strength of our program is through recruiting we found excellent people in our to have it within our program, guys who want to get better every day. And just been a pleasure to coach these guys, and I feel very fortunate to be heading on another journey with them this year. So our challenges are plenty, to replace and improve upon our offensive numbers. I know that will be a focus as we look at the success of Victor Stahlberg, and want to congratulate him on what appears to be a spot on the Leafs roster early on. And I know everybody's questioning how we're going to replace him. We've had that problem in the past, and our guys have risen to the occasion. And there's no reason why to think that our current players, when they're given more opportunities, that they will rise to the challenge. I think that's obviously something we're excited about. Increasing our offensive mindset while maintaining our good defensive fundamentals. We want to improve our special teams, no question about it. I look back at it and it's somewhat amazing that we made it all the way to the Frozen Four with one of the worst penalty kills in the country. You don't often see that. So that's something that we look forward to improving upon this year, and as well as having a consistent power play. I think those are great challenges to have early on. And probably the biggest challenge is our schedule. It starts this Sunday against one of the best teams in Canada. New Brunswick's won the Canadian Championship in 2007 and 2009, and I think they were runner-up in 2008. So they know how to play the game. It should be a great challenge for us early on here, and we're excited to play them. And it really, from that point on, it doesn't get any easier. Playing the number two Denver would be a great trip for our guys. And then we jump into league play against Boston College. So these are great challenges. I know our guys are excited to embrace these challenges and more. As I said, they're just a hungry group, and can't wait to get going this weekend.